Welcome to the vlog. Show you my new oxygen tank. How's that? Because every time I do something, I can't breathe. Even if it's just going to the bathroom, getting up and going to the bathroom, which is not very far. I have this new device. It's not really a camera. It's a Digitrax. It scans my heart to check to make sure that I'm in AFib all the time. It goes off and on, off and on. And that's what he's worried about. I have a valve that's leaking blood. And, I can't breathe. I'm struggling. Anyway, I wanted to make this YouTube video today because I made one in a live stream in the hospital, and I had my nurse there, and we were talking, and I was telling you what happened, and that all got erased. I don't know what happened to it, but anyway, so I want to tell you a little bit about what happened to me. On the 30th, I was working, I was helping my friend do some brush. This huge pain in my chest right here, and I thought, oh my god, what is this? I thought it was heartburn, because that's what it felt like. I wasn't having any pain radiating down my arm or nothing like that, so I have no clue what it was. I figured it was heartburn. So I drank some water, I was throwing up, I mean, I was sweating profusely. It wasn't that hot out there, and I was just having not a good time. And finally, after the fire went down a little bit, because I didn't want to just get up and leave the fire going, because it was a big, great, big, old, huge fire, and I didn't want to leave it going, so I waited for a few minutes, about 20 minutes, and then I sat down and was holding my chest like I'm doing now, and I was trying to breathe, and I couldn't, and my chest was killing me, and I was dizzy, and all this stuff was happening to me, and I didn't know what it was. I thought it was heartburn. So I finally got on the tractor after the fire burned down. I drove to the front of her house, which I never drive the tractor to the front of her house because that's where the grass is and everything. And don't want to ruin it. But I drove there, she came out, and I told her, listen, do you have any heartburn pills? Because I'm having really bad heartburn, my chest is hurting really bad. And she said, sure, and she went in, and then she started freaking out. She came out, she saw how bad I looked, and she was like, yeah, do you want me to take you to the hospital? I took some of the heartburn pills, and that didn't help. About this big, I took like three of those. That did not help at all. And she was all like, let me take you to the emergency. Let me take you to the emergency. I said, no, can you just take me home? So her husband got my stuff together and went ahead and took me home. And I got into the house. I laid down on the thing thinking that would make me feel better. And it was just hurting, hurting, hurting. Oh my God, it was hurting so bad. Pain I never felt before right here. Right here on the right hand side. And it was just killing me. I mean, it was cool. I thought I was dying. So I finally called my worker, my friend Lori, and my driver, and told her I'm gonna go ahead and take this off right now. I'm just sitting here, so I finally called my friend Lori, told her, listen, I cannot breathe. I'm having a hard time breathing. And my chest hurts, right? But I'll be right over. Well, I went here, and what, before she got here, I called 911. And when she got here, I laid back down, gave her the phone. She had aspirin, and she had nitro with her. But she couldn't find it because it had fallen down in the back seat. So anyway, she asked, we need to go in. And that I told her to tell them that we would meet her at the lumber place, because there's no way they would find me. They'd get lost just going around here. Dirt roads and stuff, it's hard to find. So I walked on my own to the car, which is out there, got in the car, and she drove me to the lumber place, which is a few blocks that way, towards down north. And we waited and waited and waited. No ambulance. I could hear them going that way. I could hear them going that way. They were lost already. So then the EMTs pulled up in the fire truck, and they got me on oxygen. They checked my blood pressure and everything, and they said, yeah, something's going on, and we're going to take you in. I was like, what are we waiting for? And they're all like, well, we're waiting for the ambulance. not here yet. This is just an EMP truck. But I was out of it. At that time, I couldn't even think straight or anything. So to make a long story short, I got in the ambulance. He hooked me up to these things all over my chest. And he, as soon as he read it, said, Stimmy. And I was like, I read that and I was like, what does that mean? And he said, basically, the computer is telling me that you're having a heart attack. That something is wrong with your heart. And I'm going to give you some nitro. He gave me 4 nitros. That didn't help. He gave me fentanyl, 2 shots or 3 shots of fentanyl. That didn't help. I mean, it was just killing me. And it's a long ways from here to Fresno. So they took me to St. Agnes. I got in. As soon as I got in, people were pulling off my clothes. I mean, they were raping me. And they were talking to me, asking me questions. And I was like, I don't know. Okay, well, this is the answer to that. And blah, blah, blah. And I mean, it didn't take 3 minutes, and I was out of my clothes and up to the, what they call the cath lab, and that's where they put a catheter in your, I know you can't see me, but I have a huge hole in my leg where they put a catheter in there and ran it up into my heart, and I wish I could have logged all this, but there's no way, I couldn't even think straight. I mean, they gave me some knockout juice, it didn't knock me out all the way. They wanted me to still be able to talk to them and ask me if that pressure was released or whatever, and I was like, no, not yet. And then as soon as they gave me a little more juice, I was kind of in and out of it. I didn't really, people were talking to me and I didn't know who they were, and I finally just they cleared it. They put a 2 stents inside there, so it was bad enough to get 2 stents put in there, I guess. And then I found out that the stents were metal, made out of metal. They're like a mesh made out of metal stuff. And I thought they were plastic, but they're not. So as soon as they did that, I felt better. I mean, it may have been the meds that I was on. I don't really know. But the doctor basically said, yeah, you almost died. He said, it's a good thing that we got you. If you would have just kept ignoring it, you probably would have died at home, and that would have been it. You know, it's a good thing that you decided to go ahead and pick up and call 911. And I'm glad I did too, because I am a hard ass. You know, sorry about that. My camera's battery went dead. Anyway, I just wanted to let you know, let me take this off. I'm really thankful that I did call 911, and everybody's been pretty much supporting me. I have a lot of support. My son is here to help me, Bunny Lord. My driver's here, Lori. She takes me where I need to go. So I'm just happy about that. It is almost time to pull this thing. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe on my videos. I am really trying to get subscribers. I have 23 subscribers, and I really appreciate you guys. And I know you guys watch my videos because I see it all the time. Just hit that like button, share it. I'm going through some shit right now with the heart attack, and I don't mind including you guys in that. I think that it helps me get better faster, sooner. And kind of gives you an idea of what my life is about. More talking about stuff. I'm going to have a Mavic video here coming up next. I did do some flying over here and over there and over there, but mostly around the ranch, because I don't want to fly it so far that it gets lost and I have to go get it, because I could not do that. And Bunny Lord is not good at that. So he's not good at tracking. I am. So anyway, I'm doing good. I'm getting healthy. In about 10 more minutes, I'm going to pull all this off. I'll be happy to get rid of it. You know how hard it is to sleep with this? It's hard. It says exactly 10 more minutes. So, hey, I'll see you guys. Keep me in your prayers. I'll keep you in my prayers. Everybody be cool. Love each other. Enjoy all those moments with your family, because they're short. I'm only 52 years old, and I could have died, and that could have been it, but I'm glad it didn't. So I'm still doing the same thing. I haven't given up doing what I like. I did not vlog for a few weeks because of the fact that I was sick in the hospital. I wish I would have got that on film for you guys, but something happened to it anyway. I know my son watched it, so he was about the only one that watched it, but that's okay. I'll be having some more live videos coming up too, so watch for that. Please subscribe. Alright? Hey, thanks a lot. Love you guys. Peace.
Okay. Another day. take that.